All right, so this is
Callen.
He's my coworker, and today we're gonna be kind of reviewing his what is this?
Ats-v
2016 Ats-v, which also happens to be year of my car. But this thing trumps my car in every way possible. I mean, it's got what kind of power plant does this car have?
Twin turbo V3.6 liter V6 running around 460 some odd crank horse, translates to 400 wheel torque.
Okay. Yeah, the styling of this vehicle, I love the styling of this vehicle. Before you owned this, you had an FRS, right?
I had a 2013 FRS.
And how does this car compare to that 2013 FRS?
Way more up and go.
Way more up and go, for sure. And what's your favorite thing about this ATS right here?
Probably the turbo noises.
Yeah, turbo noises.
The factory Recaros are pretty nice.
For sure.
Compared to the bucket seats in the FRS.
For sure.
Just the fact that it's a bigger engine, it's got two turbos rather than one.
Yep.
It's my second turbo car ever.
Okay. And what, now everyone has something they dislike about their vehicle. What would be the one dislike about this? If you have any. I mean, this thing's awesome.
Probably the price of parts.
Yeah, price of parts.
Because it's a Cadillac, it's way up there.
Yeah, and you just put an intake system on it, correct?
Yep, just an intake right now.
Yeah, just an intake, so there's not like anything overly done to the car?
Nope, pretty much stock.
Okay, and what, do you have any plans with this car?
Hopefully, down pipes and a tune, and it should bring me around the 500 to 525 wheel horsepower mark.
Okay, and it's probably way quicker than FRS too, huh?
Absolutely.
Yeah, for sure.
Over double the wheel horsepower.
Okay.
Almost triple the torque.
Oh, 100%. And so, with this vehicle, what's your favorite thing about the exterior? What's that?
The exterior? I'd have to go with the hood.
The hood?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, this, when I was taking shots of it, for the video, I saw this and I was like, okay, this is actually really cool. The body lines on the hood look fantastic, and it makes the car look so aggressive. And you guys will see that in the edit that we'll do of this car when the video gets to that. Now, when it comes to the interior, I'm looking at the seats. Those things look fucking sick. They look like racing seats.
They pretty basically are.
Yeah. And so what's your favorite thing about the interior?
I'd have to definitely say the seats.
Yeah.
Power Recaros with heated seats.
With heated seats.
They're heated. So that'll be perfect for the winter.
For sure. The interior looks awesome on this car.
Really dirty.
And this paint looks kind of like, almost like metallic-y,
yeah.
I would say. Would that be the right word to use?
I think it's called frostbite. I never actually looked
at frostbite? That's the color code?
Frostbite.
Frostbite. Okay. And then you have, what was it, quad tips on the back here?
Yep, quad tips with exhaust valves. So when I put it into track mode, those two valves on the inner exhaust will open up.
Okay.
And give it a very deep tone.
Awesome.
Compared to the quiet, mellow when it's an economy.
All right, sweet. All right, well, so that is interviewing the owner for this first time here. And then I think he also agreed for us to go for a little bit of a ride, kind of get a genuine reaction to the power. I'm obviously used to 250 horsepower. That is like nothing that this car is probably going to be. So that's going to be interesting. But all right, let's cue the edit for the video, and then we'll get in the passenger seat and react to this thing.
That's my nigga. I made him a million. Now fuck it, we Irish. I ain't trying to have babies right now, so we fuck with a rubber, but I got a raw bitch. Know this money bring Evie. You probably won't beat me, but bro, we can't be about no small shit. Overseas got a crowd doing my shit. Can't believe that I'm still in apartments. Businessman went and got me in office. Million dollar deals, I get them often. Me and Dollar was serving on Spawn Street. Holla G, he gon' stay with the chopstick. I got raw.
So we are inside the ATS, and first reactions, these seats hug you. I thought the Recaros in my car really hugged you tight, but these, I can tell, really, wow, there's a lot of support, and they are extremely comfy. These are full leather?
I believe it's leather and suede.
Suede, they're comfy. I mean, you get that Cadillac feel out of these seats. It feels great. The interior is magnificent. I love the interior on it, and it's got paddle shifters. Are those, is that when you put it into sport mode? Is that when you...
I can use them whenever.
Whenever?
Yep.
Well, when you're using paddle shifters, if you don't shift at a certain point, will the car shift for you?
In track mode, it won't.
In track mode, it won't.
Nope. So in track mode, it'll just be at whatever RPM you want. You can bang it off the limiter if you really, really want to.
Okay, and is the, are there different mode? Is it just track mode and like normal mode, or is there?
There's touring, which would be your economy, you know, smooth driving.
Right.
Old person mode, fuel economy.
Right.
And then there's sport when you want a little bit more pep in your step.
Okay.
And then there's snow and ice when it's the winter time because rear wheel drive is not very fun. And then there is track mode, and that really brings out every ounce of what this car has.
Right. Did you say that it has all wheel drive?
Rear wheel.
Rear wheel, okay. So it's got quite different modes. It's got the, this is a very Cadillac infotainment system.
Yeah.
It's kind of got like the emblem kind of thing is what I get out of it.
Yep.
At least it kind of looks like that with the buttons and stuff.
Yep.
So for the infotainment screen, is it pretty responsive and pretty nice or?
It's good. It does what it needs to, but
right.
There's problems with it freezing, and what ends up happening is if that happens and you know what, usually it's like a $60 screen.
Right.
You replace the screen. If the screen doesn't fix it, you're gonna end up replacing the entire infotainment center, which kind of sucks, but you know, it is what it is.
Oh yeah, for sure. I mean, it is a 2016. Well, that's 7-8 years old now, maybe six.
Seven. One on eight.
Yeah, I'm not very good at math. and I have a 2016, and I'd say that my infotainment is kind of, it feels outdated.
Mm-hmm.
But I think that's just kind of how, when you try to incorporate like a really fancy infotainment, that's kind of what happens.
Yeah.
So. That was, what did we start out at?
That was about 30.
It's got, it definitely feels, I mean, you know, it's going to be in high RPMs at 30. I don't know what gear you had it in. But
that was second.
That pulled a lot harder at 30 than it did at 60, that's for sure. It's usually how it goes, though. Oh, this car is awesome. It sounds so good. I can't get over that. I didn't think that. The camera is picking up those turbo noises and the engine itself. It sounds so good. This car sounds great. And I'm not one to enjoy the sound of many six cylinders, but genuinely I do like the sound of this thing. I think really the only other V6 that I can think of right now in my mind that I like would be like the GTR. I don't know what motors do those have?
I don't even know the engine code.
Yeah, I'm not sure the engine code.
Really, any boosted car, you know, whether it's a 4, 6, 8.
I mean, that's
they
fair.
They all pretty much sound really good.
That's fair. I guess I'm not one to really.
Even the VQs, when they're boosted, they sound decent.
You know, I could.
That's saying something.
I could partially agree with that. I'm a big hater of VQs. And it's funny because we both work at the Nissan dealership.
Yep.
But I'm not a fan of VQs. But I guess I could get on board with the fact that they do sound good boosted. All right, so that is the ATS, Cadillac Ats-v. And this is Callen. Thank you so much for letting me review your car. He's also my coworker, so I'll see him again tomorrow. So it's not like a farewell. But this car had some amazing power, beautiful car. And I'm really excited to go through this footage and look at it and put it together. And I can't wait to put it out on YouTube. So it's going to be a lot of fun. But anyways, thank you.